imaginations. There was a time my imagination was that if a man, as a growing up child, touch me, if I sit beside a man, I will get pregnant. It's imagination. Because that was our understanding. Because we don't really understand that it's more to sitting down together. Imaginations. Weird imagination. Weird thoughts. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
These imaginations prepare our mind to taking the wrong decisions in life. It makes us to set barriers ourselves. And these barriers become darkness. Imagination. You don't get it. When your mother doesn't greet another family, automatically you make those members of that family your own enemies as well.
That's right.
Meanwhile, God might have positioned somebody in that family to do you good. But because in your own imagination, your family has said that, our family is not here, but I do here. And because of that, you cut away from them. Anywhere you see them, you mark them. Let me tell you something today. The fact that my father is an armed robber does not make me an armed robber. Sir, the fact that my mother is a prostitute does not make me a prostitute. Hello? Say, continue that scripture, ma'am.
For the weapon of our warfare.
For the weapon of our warfare. They are not the way we see them.
But mighty in God for pulling down strongholds.
Yes, ma'am. They are not as we see them. Many challenges we have in life are not as we see them. Standing here on the 22nd of June, I was diagnosed with breast cancer stage 4. And the doctors told me I will die in 6 months. 6 months is on Thursday, sir. Daddy, Thursday, December 22. After 6 months, Tony Marku, Emire, Eva Mikaleluya. Imagination, understand your cancer. The news alone has broken you down. The news have killed you. The imagination in your understanding has destroyed you. Amen. You don't understand. Back in Nigeria, when they say you have cancer, man, no swelata. Understanding. Oh, you don't get it. If you don't begin to put down those scales, tell the person beside you, remove that scale. And let your brain clear. So you can move forward. When the word of God says, the thought I have towards you is of good. To give you a hope and a future. You don't get it. But then, the imagination of what you've had in the past has hooked you to a position. A position that you just become rendered useless. You will never be useless again in today.
Amen.
I said you will never be useless again.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Woman of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Desertion. You don't know what it means? Desertion and rejection. You don't get it. When you are deserted, in your own imagination, you are supposed to go to depression. Desertion renders people into depression. Desertion sends you into frustration. Rejection sends you into frustration. But when you have allowed understanding, you put down that stronghold. Daddy, me there, Sheba, I see me. Me, Tero, I don't ever thought my uncle could treat me like this. I never thought in my own imagination that this my this man that I respected so much, that he could disgrace me like this. I never even thought that this my boyfriend could leave me. 5 days to my wedding, the man walked out on me. And so bloody words. Explain my language. You are not the first that will experience it. What has happened to you is that God has only just aborted a marriage that would have destroyed your future. Amen.
Amen.
The imaginations of household wickedness, of enemy of us in Christian belief, that we believe in enemy so much that our head are dull. Pata, pata. Hello?
Hi.
What am I talking? When you believe too much in certain things, other. Amen?
Amen.
It destroys you. Now, sit down and begin to wonder, instead of the woman of God taking the bull by the horn and starting the ministry and continuing where the Lord has led her, hallelujah, and taking it by the bull and riding on the horse of the Holy Spirit as the Lord has graced her since her husband's demise. Amen.
Amen.
And then she sits. Because she allowed her imaginations, she allowed her understanding of the issue in the flesh to weigh her down. But come on now, if you connect by the Spirit of the God with the Lord, if you connect by the Spirit of the Lord, and then the quickening spirit will come and say, oh girl, I began to see a woman of God that will be going around the whole world and declaring the truth of God. How be it if you were not deserted? How would you have been empowered? If you had remained where a pastor had to pastor over you, how would you have been able to grow? You will see expressly how the Lord will form you.
Amen.
Depression is not your portion again. Christ on your feet, I reject it. Father, in the name of Jesus. Depression is not my portion. In the name of Jesus, I receive grace and above every depressive mood. In the name of Jesus, I receive grace above evil reports. I receive grace above rejection. In the name of Jesus, let us be seated. Amen.
Amen.
I remember when I got my cancer diagnosis in June. That doctor will come to me at North Muslet Hospital. Very, very learned. But the Bible says to me in my book of 1 Corinthians, you know, so only I will make useless, the foolish, the wisdom of the wise, the counsel of the wise, those that are learned. No more, he said, I will make it useless. It's not useless now. Hello? I say over you, the judgment of the world will come to nothing.
Amen.
Away. Hello? Stop on diagnosing cocoa. Hello? New one, a very brilliant doctor. But there is another doctor that is more than another doctor. So you have to drop the knowledge in the imagination and then connect with knowledge in the spiritual realms for you to be able to be made whole. Oh God. Continue, ma.
Casting down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God.
Now, another translation says, casting out every imagination. What's that translation? King James Version.
Casting down imaginations.
Casting down imaginations.
And every high thing
that exalts itself above the knowledge of God. God is all in all. Tell somebody beside you. Now, you can now ask, how then can certain things hype themselves above the knowledge of God? It's by feeding you with worms. Hello?
Hi.
You don't get it?
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm a woman that have passed through diverse situations in life. I have seen all. I am not so old. I am not too young. But God has given me experiences that my mother did not have. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has given me experiences that my grandmother did not have. Also, so holy. But I give God the glory because today they have all come together to work goodness in my life. And that's how I'm standing here today. Amen.
Amen.
How do this knowledge appear to be above the knowledge of God? What is above the knowledge of God are things, thoughts, that are not thoughts of God. Tell somebody beside you. Every thought that is not of God
is above the knowledge of God.
Don't take it in.
Don't take it in.
If you take it in, you kill yourself. Amen.